trying to pick the right purse is always a challenge.
I bought it at Goodwill. I carry everything in it.
It was actually a hand-me-down. She was going to donate it to Goodwill.
Because it's such a wonderful memory for me.
I like a purse that I can just sling around my shoulders and go.
It's where I can put a bunch of stuff in, I can throw a bathing suit in, and I can put a sweatshirt in it.
It was on my bucket list for 6 years from the age of 24.
Sometimes you need more than one. Sometimes all you need for the day is your cell phone, your ID, some cash, and of course lipstick.
It was my mother's, and it reminds me of how generous she was.
So it represents, for me, a sense of strength.
But other days, you need the workhorse.
So I need one that has like a bunch of zippers, an extra pocket.
Sometimes I even carry diapers in it. I have a new grandbaby.
I turned 30, left my marriage, and also was very sick and almost died. And I lived through all of it, and it's still here. And here's my purse.
I take it everywhere I go.
It reminds me of generosity, which makes me think about our needs at the Goodwill Inn.
Women can make such a difference in each other's lives.
One of the most important things is you can never underestimate the power of a woman.
Women who have been thrown upon tough times or have had a difficult situation in their life, I want to be able to help empower them and build them up.
The Goodwill Inn means so many things to so many different people.
The Goodwill Inn provides such an incredible opportunity for growth in our community.
What Goodwill Inn is doing is really important to our community. I think any of us could be in a situation where we need some extra support.
And if one of us is doing better, then we should reach back and help others. The Goodwill Inn is fantastic for that.
They take a hand up as opposed to hand out approach. They empower those staying at the shelter to better themselves instead of just giving out, you know, emergency needs and emergency handouts.
It's just a wonderful thing that Goodwill can create from the beginning of the road to the end of the road, putting somebody on their feet.
I think an investment in the Goodwill Inn is an investment in our community, and the reality is any of us could end up in this situation that the people that are using the Goodwill Inn right now are in, and we just need to remember that. And so a small investment, $100 or $200 right now, is small for us. I mean, if we look back next year and think we gave $100 or $200, it's not going to be life-changing for us. It's not going to break our bank, but for the people of the Goodwill Inn, it could be life-changing.
People should support the Goodwill Inn because at the end of the day, how many opportunities do you get to help somebody where you literally are helping transform a life?
You know, those simple essentials that can make a woman feel confident about the way they look, and then that's going to help them feel confident in their life, whether it's going to a job interview or going to their job and just being the best person they can. So those essentials that we probably take for granted, that's gonna help the Goodwill Inn provide those services to those women in need.
And so as I'm crossing the street, a gentleman comes out from Horizon Books and says hello to me. And I thought it was someone that I work with at one of my clients. And I said, hi, how are you today? And this man who was on crutches and had his baseball cap pulled down low looked at me and said, honestly, ma'am, I'm not very good. And I stopped. I'm sorry. I traveled halfway around the world and saw homelessness like I'd never seen. And here it was, facing me now, as I'm about to go have a beautiful meal with a dear friend. I learned so much in that moment about non-judgment and that this really is in our community. I didn't have to go to India to see that. It was right here. And what I knew to be true in that moment was, I don't know what situation got that man here, and it is not my place to judge. But I'm hoping that by that level of giving and just that spark of kindness and gratitude that I saw within him, that maybe it will inspire him to pick up the phone and reach back to somebody in his life that he loves or that loves him and ask for help. But until that time when he can, I'm grateful that the Goodwill Inn is here.
I'm an emotional girl. And I lost like everything, my kids, my home, my car. I don't want to cry. But I lost everything and Goodwill gave it back to me. You know, I was a happy housewife at one point, and I got a divorce, and I was on my own, and all of a sudden, I was doing it on my own. My husband made more money than me, so he got the kids, which I wanted that for a minute, you know, because I was living from house to house, you know, and scared to death. I needed a place, and I went to the Goodwill. When I actually went in, it's like, wow, you know, all these people are just like me, you know, and they're trying to get somewhere in life. Probably like 3 days after I got into the Goodwill Inn, I got a job at the Goodwill store. So, and that was awesome. I love my job. I absolutely love my job. I got full-time last year, and I love it. I love working with Brandon and Tom. They're all fun, and Carrie and Ben. One of the Goodwill employees told me about Bay Hill Apartments, and so I went up and talked to another lady at the Goodwill Inn, and she gave me a voucher and I got in. And I cried and cried and cried, I did. It was amazing. When I walked into my apartment for the first time, my daughter and I hugged each other and cried. And I showed her the paper that she was mine. Finally, and it was amazing. And Goodwill did get me there, helped get me there. I mean, I did it, but Goodwill was there, and it was great.